Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about strain gauge strainer kit and its order code is 52003A. So in this video we are going to discuss how it works. So this is a strain gauge strainer. This is the bridge balance zero set port. Then here there is a IC LM741. Then this is the amplifier circuit section. Then this is the 7 segment display. This is a load cell and this is the main power on off switch. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study strain measurement using strain gauges and cantilever assembly. So firstly we will connect this kit with the main supply. So we will connect a mains cord in the 3 pin section. Now we will switch on the kit and here you can see that at the display section we are getting 2.4. So we have to set this at 0 for performing the experiment. So we can set it at 0 by using this bridge balance 0 set port. So when you rotate it in clockwise direction you can see that the values are getting decreased. And now we have to set it at 0. So here you can see that I have set this value at approximately 0. This 0.1 deviation can be okay. Now we will put some weight at the load cell. So here we are having 100 gram loads like this. So here we are having 100 gram weights and it is of number 10. So we are having 100 gram weights for performing this experiment. So now we will put 100 gram weight at the center of this load cell. So here you can see the strain value. Similarly you can add again 100 gram of weight. So now the weight we have applied is 200 gram and the strain is 0.6. Now we will apply again 100 gram weight. So the total weight we have applied here is 300 gram and we are getting strain value as 0.9. Similarly you can increase the weight till 1 kg. So you have to apply 100 gram weight one by one. As we are having 100 gram weights, so it is 1 kg total. So when you apply 1 kg total weight, let's see the strain value. So here I have applied 1 kg weight. So the total weight is 1 kg and the strain is 3.1. So you can form this table which is mentioned in the manual like this. So here you can see that the load applied in gram. So these are the load we have applied. So at first you have to apply 100 gram as I have shown, then 200 gram, then 300 gram, and similarly you have to go on for 1000 gram and you have to take the readings of strain practically. So these are the values which are displayed on the 7 segment display. These are the values which you have to enter in this strain practically and you have to calculate strain theoretically by using this formula 6 into F into L divided by W into T square into Y. Here F is force, M is mass, G is acceleration due to gravity, then L is length, W is width, T is thickness, Y is Young's modulus. So that is how you can calculate strain theoretically, and you can take the strain practical values from this display. So here at 1000 gram we are getting strain practical values as 3.1, and you can calculate the theoretical value by using this formula. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we can also perform another experiment, that is to determine linear range of operation of strain measurement. So the procedure will remain same as the earlier experiment, that is when you switch on the kit you have to set this display reading at 0. So you can set this at 0 by using this bridge balance 0 set port, and after that when the display is 0 0, then you have to apply 100 gram weights one by one, and then you have to form these table again, that is load applied in gram, that is 100 200, then 300. So you have to apply 100 gram weight one by one till 1000 gram. So this is the load applied, then you have to take the readings of strain practically from this display, and then you have to calculate the strain theoretically by using the same formula, that is 6 into F into L divided by W into T square into Y. So that is how you can take the readings of strain practically, and you can calculate the strain theoretically by using this formula. And here you have to calculate percentage error also. Then you have to plot this graph between weight and display reading, that is the strain practical reading. So you can observe that when you plot the graph, so the constant line which is the theoretical strain, and you can see this deviation line, this is the display reading. So you can observe the deviation of the theoretical and practical value by plotting this graph. So this is the difference which we get when we are getting the display values and when we are calculating the theoretical strain values. So you can also calculate percentage linearity by using this formula, that is percentage linearity is equal to maximum deviation of display reading from theoretical strain into 100 divided by theoretical strain for 500 gram. So that is how you can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.